guys, David Glenn for davidglennrecording.com, mixingvocals.com, mixingacoustic.com, so the new course, and of course the proaudiophiles.com. Get that stuff out of the way. I'm going to talk to you today about sidechain, not really sidechain compression. I don't know if you call it sidechain ducking. But we've used the FabFilter Pro-MB. I've shown you that on the blog. That's a part of the courses as well. We dive deeper into that. But now what I want to show you is kind of my new friend. I haven't really switched over completely to using it, but I definitely like what it's doing. And I've actually used it a little bit on the buses as well. You'll see these two bass tracks are going to a bass level. And I'm going to put that here. And I'm going to instantiate... where do we go here? Wavesfactory Trackspacer. Some of you guys may know about this one. Pretty sweet stuff going on with this. I've got my kick here, kick level there. The kick goes out via a bus. I've got that there. It's called Kick SC. I need to pull that in up here. This is the sidechain. I'm going to go here. I've got it selected now. Now the kick is sending into this plugin. The plugin's getting its information from the kick drum. And then I'm going to be able to click this little dot, this little circle over here in the bottom corner. I'm going to select sidechain. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to dial in my attack and release. I'm going to I think that's what's going to help me listen to the sidechain. Yeah, you can hear it's flaming because of the bus routing. No big deal. But now we know that that's working. Our sidechain is set up correctly. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to exaggerate the junk out of the ratio. I'm going to boost that quite a bit, and I'm going to take, for the kick drum and the bass, I only want a specific range to be pushed down. What this plugin essentially is going to do is it's going to push down the bass based on whatever frequency range that I set, however many dB based on the ratio. So I hope I'm explaining that well, but see here, the low pass is set to 20. I can leave that there. The high pass, I'm going to pull that down somewhere in the range of 100, maybe like a 1, 110, 120, something like that. Let's try that. And then what it's going to do is we'll get rid of this menu. It's going to push down the bass, and you'll see a graphic here, every time the kick hits because it's receiving the signal from the kick drum. Bypass it. Pretty crazy, right? Now we're sending a pretty conservative level. We could probably send this a little bit, exaggerate it. All right, now you hear kind of that pumping vibe going on. So it's pretty straightforward. I mean, if you're following me, 20 hertz to about 116 or so is getting pushed down by the kick every time the kick hits in the bass guitar. So pretty sweet way to try to blend in more of that low from the kick and help both of them kind of sit there. The only thing you want to be careful of is with this, it definitely feels like a hole in your bass guitar if you aren't gentle with it. So what I would recommend is finding the settings, coming over here, boosting it like that. You can come back in here and dial in your attack and release. Let's set the release really long so we can hear this thing just really insanely exaggerated. You hear how there's like no lows in the bass? Well, that's because the release is not coming back in time for the next kick hits. The kicks just continue to push it out of the way. So now if we dial in the attack a little bit quicker, we want it to be quick, and then I'd like it to be super quick, almost like a really tight gate that's allowing it to open and close in a way that just allows that just a little bit of pulse from the sub kick region in the kick drum to hit the bass down. So let's pull this release back. Yeah, so I'm finding that a faster release is really helping the kick to come through, get it out of the way, and not to miss too much of that bass. And obviously, this is exaggerated. So then what I recommend is dropping the percentage down to zero and then sliding it up a little bit. And then bypass. Yeah, it almost sounds kind of flat whenever we bypass it. Play that back a little bit. I want to give a shout out to my buddy Joey Fernandez for hooking me up out of Chicago, telling me about the Wavesfactory. Pretty cool plugin. I'm digging it. And then something else I'm using it for, let me go ahead and share that. Probably don't have the tracks active, but I've got these all buses here, and I talk way more about these in my training courses. But let's say that you had a lead vocal, and your music was built up a little bit in the 800 to 2K range, where the vocal sweet spot tends to be, somewhere in there. Let's say that you had your music was built up a little bit too much in that area, but you like the way the music sounds whenever the vocalist isn't singing. Well, then you could pull in that Wavesfactory track spacer, and you could set the range to be anywhere from like that 800, 900 to 2K region, 1.5, something in there. And then you can dial just a hint of the ratio so that anytime the vocalist is singing, she'll push down the music in that frequency by just a tiny bit. I mean, obviously you can get crazy with it and push it really hard, but be careful not to go too far. But ultimately, do the same thing. You're going to come in here, set up a bus to receive from the vocal. In this case, you could do all vocals, but I would probably pull up in your lead vocal and send from your lead vocal into the all music. So there's another handy way that you can control allowing the lead vocal to dominate that frequency range when she or he is singing. But then whenever there are no vocals, the music can live and dominate that mid-range the way that you may like it to. So little tip on using Wavesfactory Trackspacer. I hope that you enjoy that. Feel free to share it, like, subscribe, message the groups, blast these out. Hopefully we can get more people coming and subscribing. That helps us a ton, continues to help us to bring you free content. We really appreciate you guys supporting us. David at davidglenrecording.com. There's a podcast soon to be coming your way with interviews and all kinds of good stuff. A membership site is in the works with session files, all kinds of great stuff to come from that. Don't forget to check out mixingacoustic.com, the new premium training course, mixingvocals.com, theproaudiophiles.com is a mouthful, and all the great stuff that we have coming your way soon. So anyways, hope you love this. We'll talk to you soon. Thanks again.